Namaste students. Now today we'll see our new textbook. This year we have from that textbook exercise 1.1 express as rational numbers. We all seen how we define rational numbers. Integer upon integer number is called rational numbers. Now we will go express as rational numbers. Now first sum is given 11, second sum given -52.25, third sum given 2 upon 2 above 1 by 3. Now as rational number is in integer upon integer form, so first answer what it comes, 11 in rational form, 11 upon 1. This is in rational number because integer upon integer. Second sum, -52.25. Now minus we put as it is. 52 means 5 to 2 5 upon, after decimal two numbers, two digits are there, so 1 after 2 zeros if you will give. This is in the form integer upon integer. Further, if we want to write, we can write in standard form. But as it is given expressed just in rational numbers, so this answer is okay. Third sum, 2 integer 1 by 3 is equal to. We know how to make this in improper fraction. Denominator we write as it is, 3 into 2 plus 1. So what it comes, 3 2s are 6 plus 1 7, 7 upon 3. So first answer is 11 upon 1, integer upon integer. Second answer, integer 5225 and 100, integer upon integer. This is negative rational number, and this is not in rational form, this is in mixed fraction. We wrote in 7 upon 3, this is rational numbers, integer upon integer. We'll go next question. Here second question asked is, every integer a rational number? Yes, every integer is a rational number. Is 0 a rational number? Yes, 0 means 0 upon 1, and 0 upon 1, 0 is integer, denominator 1 integer, so it is yes. Does the largest rational number exist because rational numbers are infinite? No. Is 0 upon 0 a rational number? No, because the definition what we seen, the number which is in P by Q form, where P and Q both are integers. P is integer, Q is integer, but Q not equal to 0. Denominator 0 is not permissible in maths because it becomes meaningless. So this is the definition. So denominator is here 0, so this is not a rational number. No, means is 0 upon 0 a rational number? No. Is 6 upon 0 a rational number? No, because denominator is 0. By definition, it is not a rational number. We'll go next sum. Fill in the blanks. -2/9 is equal to equivalent fraction we write now. Now we know that 9 into what is 63. -2/9, I told that property. What we multiplies to 9, it becomes 63. 7, 9 7 is 63. So same 7 I have to multiply here. 2 into 7 what will come? 14 will come. This minus as it is. So in the fill in the blanks what will come? 14 will come. And here minus as it is. Or minus 14 we write in box. Now next, -2/9. Here needed 81. Denominator needed 81. So we have this -2/9. So 9 into 9 is 81. So same 9 I have to multiply here. So -2 into 9, what? 2 9s are 18, and minus 18. So here what it comes? -18. Similarly, here second sum, minus 3 upon minus 7 it is there. Here we needed 28. Minus 7 and minus 3 is here. What we to multiply to minus 7, it becomes plus 28. So here we needed 7, 4 is 28 and minus needed. Is minus into minus becomes plus and 7, 4 is 28. So minus 4 comes here. So minus into minus here it is plus and 3, 4 is 12. So what it comes? Plus 12. Next sum. Here we to make that box. Minus 3 upon minus 7 we have. We need here minus, they given here minus 21. So we to find this number. Here it is the number, it is in this form. So we to find a number here, what to multiply, then it becomes minus 21. 3 sevens are 21. Minus into plus, minus. So same 7 I have to multiply down. So here comes 7 sevens are 49. And this minus into plus, minus. So what it comes? Minus 49. Minus 49. Now, next. Check if the following are equivalent. Here, two sums given. Minus 7 upon 11 and 49 upon minus 77. Are they equivalent? Means are they equal or not? They ask. Now, by the property, if I will multiply as the denominator is minus 77, if I multiply minus 7, here it comes minus 77. Then minus into minus plus 7 sevens are 49. So by the property, these two are what? Equivalent. Equivalent. Second sum. Minus 12 upon 77 is there. We to simplify and we to find. That also one method. Just what? If it cut with any divisor, then we to cut it. Or else we to put as it is. Here 12 have divisors 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. This has only two divisors, 7 and 11 and 77. So this remains as it is, it not simplify. But here, if we cut with the 2's table, 2 1's are 2 8's are, 2 2's are 2 5's are. Further it will cut, 2 9's are, not cuts, 18 and 25 remains as it is. So these two are not equivalent. Now next sum. Minus 5 upon 11. If what multiply will get minus 33. Here compulsory we to multiply minus 3. Then only 11 3s are 33 and this minus. If I multiply with minus 3, minus into minus plus 5 3s are 15 plus 15. Same it is that. No, it is given minus. So it is not equivalent. Not equivalent. Next, write equivalent rational numbers for minus 2 upon 7 with the following denominator. The denominator is needed minus 28. So minus 2 upon 7. Minus 2 upon 7. We needed a denominator minus 28. So what to multiply here? 7 into minus 4. 7 into minus 4 comes 28. 7 4s are 28. Plus into minus, minus. So minus 7, minus 4. Minus into minus plus 2 4s are 8. Next sum. Second sum. We have, it is given minus 2 upon 7 fraction. Minus 2 upon 7. We need here the denominator is 49. So 7 7s are 49. So here comes 7. Minus 2 into 7, minus 14. So this is the answer. Next sum. Express the following as rational number with positive denominator. You have to write this denominator in positive form. I told once that if a minus a upon b it is there, if I multiply with a minus 1 numerator denominator, minus into minus becomes plus, plus into minus becomes minus. So minus a upon b we can write a upon minus b. Means we can change this denominator minus to the numerator also. Mostly in standard form, in rational number, the denominator must be positive integer. So with that method, we can write this minus 8, we to write minus 7 upon 8. So this is with positive denominator. Now here, minus minus both cancels. So it becomes 4 upon 9. So this denominator is positive integer. We'll go next. Are the following rational numbers positive or negative? They ask. Now first one, minus 3 upon 9. Now for denominator, there is no cancellation of minus. So this remains minus as it is. So this is negative rational number. Second, this minus 2 upon minus 7. This minus minus cancels. So this is what it is, positive rational number. Now third one, it is already positive, no negative sign only. So 4 upon 9 is what? Positive rational number. Last one, this denominator minus we can write to numerator, all the minus will not cancel. So this is fourth one is what? Negative rational number. Here, eighth question. Express the following rational number in the standard form. Standard form means what? We simplify numerator, denominator. If have any common divisor, then denominator we have to make positive. So here in first sum, 2 upon 22 is there. It will cut with 2's table. 1 upon 11. This is in standard form. Second, minus 9 upon minus 99. Here, minus minus cancels. 1 upon 11. So this is in standard form. Third sum, 7 upon minus 63. As it cut with 7 table, 7 ones are 7, 7 nines are. So 1 upon minus 9. Denominator minus, we to write to numerator, minus 9 upon 1. So this is in standard form. Last sum, fourth sum, minus 11 upon 33. It will cut with 11 table. 11 ones are, 11 threes are. Minus 1 upon 3. So this is in standard form. We'll go next question. Check if the following pair of rational number are equal. Are they equal or not? We to see is it a equivalent fraction or not. First one, minus 11 upon 8. And second one given, 33 upon minus 24. Either we to simplify, we to see they are equivalent, or else we to multiply the denominator, make denominator equal or numerator equal, then we will get them. So it is better to see if we make one denominator or one numerator same, then is it get that fraction or not, then only it is equivalent. Now 8 threes are 24. If I multiply minus 3, then it become minus 24. Then same minus 3, if I multiply minus into minus plus, 11 threes are 33. So this first case, these both are equivalent. Second sum, minus 12 upon 9 and 60 upon 45. If I will multiply with 5, 9 5s are 45. Same 5 if I multiply, 12 5s are 60, but here it comes a minus 60. but here given plus 60. So these are not equivalent. Third sum. 6 upon 7. If I wrote 6 upon 7 and I want to make denominator or numerator. Suppose numerator I need minus 36. So 6, 6 is 36. Minus if multiplies, minus comes. So minus 6 if I multiply here, we have to check whether it is minus 42. Yes, 7, 6 are 42 and plus into minus, minus. So these are equivalent. Next. Fourth sum, 1 upon 5 upon 1, it is clearly not equivalent. It is not equivalent because 1 upon 5 is 1/5 and 5 upon 1 is 5. Next, fifth sum, minus 14 upon minus 20, it is. We can multiply also, we can divide also. Numerator, denominator, it comes the same. We will go reverse way. 7 upon 10, what to multiply, we'll get minus 14 upon minus 20. You see, if I multiply here minus 2, 10, 2 is 20, 10, plus into minus, minus. So minus 2, if I multiply, we'll get what? Minus 14. So these are equivalent. Next sum. Represent the following on the number line. On the number line, 2 upon 3. Now, denominator says how many equal parts we have to make of one unit. Suppose if I will take here 0 and here 1, 2, 3 parts I made and I wrote 1. 1, 2, 3 parts I made, I wrote. Same this side, 1, 2, 3 parts minus 1. 1, 2, 3 parts minus 2. So in one unit, I made 3 parts. 1, 2, 3. 3 parts. Now here, 2 upon 3. So this is from here when you start from 0, this is 1 upon 3, this is 2 upon 3. So here is the number, what it is? 2 upon 3. Similarly here, minus 2 upon 3, this is minus 1 upon 3, minus 2 upon 3. So here it is what? Minus 2 upon 3. So this sum over, this over. Now 3 upon 4, now we have to make 4 parts of one unit. Suppose I took 0 here. 1, 2, 3, 4 parts, and here if I wrote 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, if I wrote 2 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, here if I took minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Now here 3 upon 4, I have to show that. So this, now here 4 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this is 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4. So here what it comes? 3 by 4. And this is 4 by 4 means 1. Similarly, minus 3 upon 4, we have to show that. This is minus 1 upon 4, minus 2 upon 4, minus 3 upon 4. Next, here 3 by 10, it gives 10 parts we have to make of one unit. Suppose 0 if I took here, and here one part, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I have to write 1 here. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This comes to. Similarly, that side. Now, how to find a 3 by 10 where? So, now as one unit make 10 part, each part is 1 tenth. So, this is 1 upon 10, 2 upon 10, 3 upon 10. So, here it is 3 upon 10. Next question. Now, we have to show 9 upon 3. 9 upon 3. Similarly, now if I will make 3 parts of one unit, 1, 2, 3, here comes 1, 1, 2, 3, here comes 2, 1, 2, 3, here comes 3. So similarly, 1, 2, 3, here comes 4 and 5 and 6 and so on. This side 1, 2, 3, here minus 1 comes. Means one unit's 3 parts we have to make that. Now 9 upon 3 means from here if we will go for positive side 9 upon 3, 1 upon 3, 2 upon 3, 3 upon 3, 4 upon 3, 5 upon 3, 6 upon 3, 7 upon 3, 8 upon 3, 9 upon 3. This is only 3. This is what it is? 9 upon 3. If you see 9 upon 3, 9 upon 3, 3 ones are 3 threes are 3 upon 1 will come. Next, minus 9 upon 2. Now, if I took here 0 and 2 parts they made. denominator says how many equal parts made. So 1 you needs 2 parts, 1, 2. So here comes 1, 1, 2. Here comes minus 1, here minus 2, here minus 3, here minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and so on. Now we have to find minus 9 upon 2. Now each part is 1 by 2. So if we'll go this side, positive 1 by 2, 2 by 2 will come. This side will come minus 1 by 2, minus 2 by 2, minus 3 by 2, minus 4 by 2. Like that, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9. So this is minus 9 upon 2. So this sum or that sum or 8th sum. 2 by 7. Now we have to make 7 equal parts. If I take 0 here, how many parts we have to make? 7 parts. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have to take suitable distance in compass. We have to just draw the number line. And we to make a denominator, what says that many parts we to make, and then we have to set 0, then 1, 2, and minus 1, minus 2. Similarly, here 2 over will come 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So here 2 comes. Now we'll go there 2 by 7. So this is 1 by 7, this is 2 by 7. 2 over 7. This says where the position, where the 0, where the 1, where the 2, then where the given number, that is 2 by 7. Next, minus 13 upon 5, minus 13 upon 5. If I take 0 here, then if I make 5 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here it comes to minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here comes minus 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here comes minus 3, and so on. We'll see now minus 13 upon 5. Again, we'll make there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here minus 4 comes. Now, where the position will come, see minus 13 upon 5. That is, if we'll count from here, 1, this is minus 1 by 5. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So, here it is. Minus 13 upon 5. Now 7 upon 3, we'll see that in first sum we made 3 parts only. How many parts we made? 1, 2, 3 parts. 7 upon 3 we have to find now. From here, this is 1 by 3, 2 by 3, 3 by 3, 4 by 3, 5 by 3, 6 by 3, and this is 7 upon 3. So this way we completed first exercise of the new textbook. You to make a new notebook and all the sums which I taught, write neatly with neat handwriting.